13th on Sunday. I just woke up. I'm going to show you guys how to shave properly. We're going to go through the whole day of everything I do, since people seem to find it amusing and interesting. And let's see, I'm going to show you everything I do. I have a neurotic outline and schedule of things I do. So this is what I do every morning. I get up, I get my washcloth, I brush my teeth already. You don't need to see how I brush my teeth, although I do have an electric toothbrush. That's the best way to brush your teeth. It's off all the plaque. Alright, I got my washcloth. I don't use shaving cream. I wet my face with nice hot washcloth. And then I use a, this is MD formulation facial cleanser. I don't use any soap in my face, and I don't use shaving cream. Lather up my face. And then the key is you gotta get one of these Gillette fusions. My battery ran out, so I can't vibrate it, but it's got the five flexible blades with five blades. And then I shave. And because I don't have shaving cream on my face, I think it glides better actually. I don't like without shaving cream. But I like this fusion because it's got this shaping it to shape my sideburns with it. I feel like a professional. Voila, fresh shaved face, no problems, it took 2 minutes. We're gonna get into my car now. We're going to pick up Johnny Styles and his beautiful wife, Corrine, at the airport. They just came in from the NPC Southern States. Gotta do some good deeds. We're gonna pick them up, we're gonna come back, and we're gonna do a little cycling. And I'm gonna teach you how to make this special oatmeal, egg white, I don't know, souffle, I call it, sounds better. I'll teach you how to do it. All right, we're here at Kennedy Airport looking for Johnny Styles. Coming in from Florida. A little NPC Southern Estates coverage. And usually I'm the one being picked up, but I am doing the picking up in Terminal 4 here at JFK Airport. Those of you who might be interested. There they are. They look very tired. I bet Johnny Styles slept 3 minutes the whole night. Let's say, greet them.
How is Florida?
It's great.
It's a very big secret. There
we go.
Night on,
I'm good.
Corrine's actually stronger than I am, so. Look at that. Big weighs 400 pounds. That's just. Johnny Styles gets unlimited bags.
In first class, too.
All right, we just got home, and now we're going to prepare for our bike ride. I'm going to show you how to make a little oatmeal raisin treat, and look who's greeting us here, the Jadester. Jade, say hello to the camera. Hey Jade. Hey Jade. You want to go biking? Hey Jade. Wave. Wave. Come on, Janie. Wave. What happened?
Threw the fish.
Again?
Yeah, and I think they ate it.
Oh, they opened it up? Yeah, oh no.
What did they do? Oh no.
Is the door shut? Are we here?
Nope.
Shut it, because I know Jason's in there. You know, it was on the floor the other day and I picked it up right on the
past.
It didn't open. All right. right, I got some fish food now. I'm in my backyard, and I'm gonna feed my koi fish at the koi pond, so come on, follow us. It's a little noisy here. I'm on the water. All my trees are growing back. It's after the storm, it's finally regenerating. Let's see if we get the fish to eat. There's a lot of flies here, that's for sure. And then it comes. It's still growing. I'm replenishing from Hurricane Katrina. Wasn't Katrina, what was it?
Sandy.
Sandy. See, my maple tree is coming back. Except I don't think this is a miniature maple tree. This looks like a very big maple tree. I'll have to ask Amanda.
Japanese maple.
Yeah, Japanese maple. Is this a big one or a small one, though?
Big one.
Might be a big one. Maybe too big. And we're going to prepare for the bike ride. I forgot I had to feed the fish first. You know, I can show you all the fish in my house, too, but maybe we'll do that later. So I'm ready to ride. I got to put my riding outfit on. So I'm going to show you my riding outfit. Come on upstairs. Look at the strawberries. Holy shit. Holy shit. Strawberries. Look, I got strawberries. I can't believe it. I'm eating my own strawberries. They're delicious. I'm living off the fat of the land, as they say in Mice and Men. All right, we're here in my laundry room. This is floor one of my house. Three fish tanks down here. All right, this is the angel fish tank. You can see I have some marble angel fish here. I have some albino mother of pearl angels. I have some blue. This is like a technically a blue angel. These are rosy barbs down here. Very, very bright rosy barbs. I may add. And I have some little baby gold severums in here, flipping around. And that's my newest addition, that Amazon sword plant. It's an actual real plant. Some of the other ones are fake in there, but that's real. And then we move over here to the black molly tank. These fish actually are freshwater, but they like a little salt in the water, so I keep them separate. And they're doing very well. And then here's this is my original fish tank. Over here is a 55 gallon. It's kind of just like a variety tank. I have my red-tail shark in there. I have some serpe tetras, these little orange ones here. I have some baby electric blue Jack Dempsey's down there, which are pretty cool. They'll get pretty big, but they're like very wimpy when they're little. And then I have some golden Jack Dempsey's up here. Two of those also in there. So this is kind of like a growing out tank. Here's the bikes. The bikes are down here with the lights on. But we'll show these outside, so let's keep this for later. Now, who wants to get introduced?
Hey, Penny.
Come on, Penny. Let's get Diva first.
Diva, come on, Diva.
This is Diva. She's the smallest. Say hi, Dave. She's, what are you, 2.5 pounds?
Yes, I am 2.5 pounds.
She likes to show her belly. She's got her little bow in, her little strawberry bow. Say hi. Say hi. Hi, everyone. I'm Diva. She snorts a lot like a little pig, but she's tiny. Then we got Penster. Penny. Everyone knows Penny, right? Penny, give kisses. Good, she gives kisses. She's got her green bow in. She's the youngest, even though she's the biggest. Say hi. Say hi. No, you don't want to? She's shy. And then we have the Abster, Abby. She didn't do her hair today, so she's like, excuse me. Say hi. Hi. And then we got the Belzer. Come here, Billy. Bella's the oldest. She's my original. Good girl. Give me a say hi. Say hi, stick that tongue out. Hi everyone, I'm Bella. Good girl, okay. That's all the puppies. And then we have the living room tank here. This is my living room fish tank. This is a red ruby Oscar. It's an albino platinum Oscar. That is a ballo, a tricolor shark that's very big. You can see some little sucker catfish on the side. And there is a Giardini arowana. You're looking at it in the back. He's a little not so out there. We just put him in this tank. Then I have an electric blue Jack Dempsey in the back of the tank, which is huge.
He's a bigger version of what we saw downstairs. I don't know why he's hiding, but he is. This is my discus tank, which is actually, it's got a lot of different fish in this tank. I could probably talk about this tank for hours. These are discus fish though. As you can see, they look like discus. The discus that they throw in the Olympics. They're round, disc-like fish. We have albino melons, we have bullnose blues, we have sunset discus, we have albino rabbit, white rabbits. We got a lot of different ones here. And we have a lot of other various fish. We have Rosaline sharks and Serpe, longfin Serpe tetras, and albino crebensis right here. We have rummy nose. See the red nosed ones, tetras? Pretty cool. And it's a very active tank. I'm trying to put live plants in it now, so it's a little sparse, but we're slowly seeding it. Then we move into the back bedroom, as we call it. Or the horn room, as it's known as. And we have some big discus in here that are breeding, hopefully. And we have some neon tetras over there, and then if you look down to the bottom tank, we have some fancy tail guppies there that are breeding, the little babies. Swimming around. Okay. This is my big Oscar tank. These are the big boys. He's been around with me the longest. That's a red ruby Oscar. If you notice, doesn't have a stitch of black on him. He's very good quality. We have a big albino tiger Oscar behind him. I think they're a pair. I think they're an item in this thing. And we have a little lyra tail, or very long-tailed Oscar. He should have a little more white in him. He's looking a little dirty looking. These are gold severins. Probably one of the biggest gold severins you'll see. The one in the back is the biggest. That's a male. And they seem to, I think it's a male with two females. This is a great tank, this is a 180. Then if you come over here, these are some new tanks we got. This is my flower horn. He's a monster. We don't know what he is, he's a mutant fish. He's like a bodybuilder. And he doesn't like any other fish, we'd have to keep him all by himself. Because otherwise he'll kill the other fish. And he likes to bite our fingers too when we feed him. And the tank below here, you can't see the fish in here because he's hiding. But he's an albino clown knife, I promise you. Maybe we can get him out. Maybe we can scare him out a little bit. Let's see if we can get my hand in there and get him to play a little bit. Here he comes. That's a beautiful fish. It's an albino clown knife. He's going back into hiding. You got a quick peek at him. And in the final tank is in my bedroom on the third floor. And these are the flower horns, kind of similar to the other ones we showed you, but this is a pair. This is a male, and this is the female. The male has a huge head, if you can see, and they like to get their head petted. You can see it. They like to get their head rubbed. But if you let them, don't watch out, you'll get your hand bit off. They want to eat. Let's see what they'll eat. They love to eat. All these fish do is eat all day. The bigger the head, the better it is, supposedly. This guy's head is a little beat up because the female bites on his head a lot. But we've been trying to breed these. But they lay eggs, but they don't hatch. I don't know. We think the male might be shooting blanks. And that's basically my fish tanks in my house. Later today, you're going to go over to the office when we record muscle in the morning, and you're going to get to see the big fish tank in the office, the 600-gallon tank. Stay tuned. All right, I'm in my bike outfit. I'm not professional yet, so I have some aspects of my outfit that are good, some that are not, according to cyclist standards. This is my bodybuilding tank top, my species tank top, so this is probably not cycling garb. I have to get the special cycling with the pockets in the back. I don't have that, so I have no pockets. I do have the cycling shorts. Now, the advantage of these things, not that I like to wear spandex, is that they have this little padding back here, so when you sit on the seat, it doesn't dig into your you-know-whats. And then I got my Nike Pegasus running shoes, but those are not right shoes, because bike shoes are supposed to have clips in the bottom that clip into the pedals. I don't have those yet. I'm not that sophisticated. But this is the outfit I've been wearing so far in my ghetto approach to cycling. I'll show you my bike in a little bit. But I told you I wanted to teach you how to make one of the quickest, best snacks. Okay, I call it a meal because it is a complete meal. And you could put different items in it. And I'm going to show you. In 2.5 minutes, you could have a good bodybuilding or aerobics type meal. It consists of oatmeal, some raisins, and some other goodies with eggs. So watch me. This is what we have to do. All right, here it is. It's quick, it's easy, and I guarantee a lot of you are going to do this, and you're going to tell me it's delicious. First thing is oatmeal. This is the base of the food we're making here. Now, you can put as much as you want. This is probably about a half a cup, so I'm going to use this now because I'm not looking to do a lot, but you can add more or less according to your needs. And I got raisins. I'm a big raisins guy, so I like raisins. Put a bunch of raisins in here, okay? And you can raisin it to your liking. Yeah. After the raisins, I put a packet of Truvia, which is basically stevia, with a little kick to it, as Emeril Lagasse would say. So we get that in there. I gotta get my fork, mix everything, stir that around. Now, I have 2 omega-3 eggs here. These are jumbo ones. I didn't even know they made them, but jumbo for Jumbo Palumbo. And you'll get 8 grams of protein per egg. I usually put 3 in there, but we're doing a quick snack, so I'm going to put 2 in here. Notice I haven't put any water in there. Now you can, sometimes I like to add a little coconut water, just for like some flavor, just a little bit. And then I take some coconut, shredded coconut pieces, and I just drop some of that in there. So you don't need a lot. Coconut goes a long way. And then you stir all this through, and you got to stir it till it kind of makes like almost like a batter, you know, out of it. I've noticed I didn't put any water. I put a little splash of coconut water, but I didn't even need that, to be honest with you. I just did it for show. And it's that easy. Now you take this, you put this in the, now if you notice I have this in ceramic, because Evan sent the potty, got me so crazy with the plastic in the microwave that I use ceramic now. You put this in the microwave 2.5 minutes. That's it. And watch what happens when it comes out. We're gonna see how our little mixture came out. Okay, very hot, 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 hot. Okay, here it is. As you can tell, I put a fork under it, it pops right out. Put it on here. Usually I take it in the car with me when I'm eating when on the way to work. And look, it's like a little cake almost. And if you want to be a neurotic, you could take a knife and you can slice it into little pieces. Eat them like little treats with your hands. I'm not that sophisticated, I break it off. But you can put these in little Ziploc bags, and you can see all the little pieces of coconut, and you got your raisins, and then the egg holds all this together, and this is your oatmeal. And this is a great treat to eat anytime, you know, during the day. It's high protein, it's high, you know, and good carbs, and it's got some good essential fats from the whole omega-3 eggs. And I take this before I go riding, this is before I go to the gym, and this is usually my morning and night meal, believe it or not, so. Salute. All right, we're ready to go for this bike ride. It's a little overcast out. Hope it doesn't start raining. You know, you never know. You get caught out there, we could get a nice little shower on us. I bought a helmet. I broke down and I did it. I know it's a safety feature you really need. I actually wanted to buy the expensive, cool-looking helmet, but I have a big head, so I had to stick with the cheap helmet, which Amanda was very happy about. Now I feel the rain coming down. So I put the helmet on. This is not like the funnest part. This is the only part I don't like. I've been riding without a helmet, so this is my first time with a helmet on. Okay, I got my Trek bike here, my Trek Madone bike, as you can see. It broke down. I got the water bottle. I don't even think I'm going to need it today because it's kind of cool out. And we're ready to go. I got my high-tech tracking device here. This will tell me how far I go and how fast I've been going, my heart rate and all that good stuff. And maybe you'll get a quick peek of me on the road to the beach.
drink one of these after my bike ride. It's the best electrolyte replacement drink because it's got the perfect balance of sodium and potassium, same as our blood serum. And I use this after I train. Really likes to drink. I'm replenishing. Now I'm going to take a shower, and you never know what we're going to do next here on a day of the life of Dave Palumbo on Sunday, July 13th. Here at one of my favorite places, Taco Joe's. I've showed you this place before. I'm not gonna go through the whole laundry list of what I got, but if you look down at my plate here, I have, underneath here, I have grilled chicken, rice, black beans are under here, I promise you they are. And then on top, I get a salad. I get mixed greens, I get peppers, cabbage, there's some tomato here, cucumbers, there's green olives. I'm into a green olives today, and walnuts, all mixed in. That's my post-cycling meal. It's actually my meal most of the days, every single day. It's healthy, but it's also filling and very calorie dense. So we go here, I'm gonna head over to probably the warehouse, and you get to see what goes on over there. Time to go into the Species Nutrition RX Muscle Warehouse offices, and you'll get to see my fish in there. You're gonna get to see me do muscle in the morning and the heavy muscle radio show. All right, welcome to the office here. This is the Species RX Muscle offices, and as you can see, as soon as you walk in, you see my showcase 600 gallon fish tank. I just fed the fish. All stuffed. They got some of them got like shrimp sticking out of their mouth. See that little black Oscar there, the red tiger Oscar. Look at this. This guy's stomach is loaded. It's the red ruby Oscar. There's my silver arowana looking for food still. Let me see. I'll give him a little more food, man. You come over here, you'll see my white, snow white albino arowanas. Here they're gonna come eat these shrimp pieces. Watch this. There they come. They're like got a shovel mouth. I think they've already eaten, so they may. Not be as hungry, but they can stuff it in their mouth, they'll eat it. There's my geophagus earth eater fish. There come the arowanas. Let's see if they're gonna snag something. He's stalking it, he hasn't eaten it yet. I'm looking for my needle nose gar. I don't see him. I hope he didn't get eaten while we were gone this weekend. Here he is, my needle nose gar. I'm gonna get a good look at him. He prefers live food, but he's pretty good. It's a reflection of it. Here's my angelfish tank over here. Some white albino Altum angels over here. There's a blue Pinoy. It looks black, but it's actually blue, they call that. Some albino paradise fish. We have a marble veil tail angel and a wild angel. That should get pretty big from what I understand. So these are the tanks here. Keeps me occupied sometimes when I need to get away from the stress of work. And in a few minutes, you're gonna see me do heavy muscle radio. All right, I'm actually on Skype now with Chris, the technician Aceto. We're about to film heavy muscle radio here. You're watching it live. This is how it happens. Chris and I did a little warm up with each other. We talk about all the funny things that we can't talk about on the air, which you guys are not gonna hear either, of course. And then we go on the air, we record, and then you hear this Monday night. I'm here at my desk. You can see to my right, my two snakes. I have my two ball pythons. The Blackie is the original. She's on the left there. You can't see her right now. I think she's under the log. And Dexter is on the right there, not Dexter Jackson, Dexter the serial killer. He's on the right, he's the white albino ball python. And this is how it happens here. So guys, you'll get the intro, you'll get to see what I do, and a little later you're gonna get to watch muscle in the morning, and this is kind of like how my day goes on Sunday when everyone else is going to church and relaxing. All right, here we go, Chris. 3, 2, 1. Welcome to another episode of Heavy Muscle Radio. I'm Dave Palumbo, and I'm joined, as always, by Chris, the technician Aceto.
It is July 14th, 2014. And Chris, we had a super moon this weekend. Do you know what a super moon is?
It sounds like a full moon on nitrilize.
Full moon on steroids.
It sounds like a full moon on IGF-3 or whatever people text me about and email me about.
We're in the RX Muscle Studios, the inner sanctum of rxmuscle.com, and we're about to do muscle in the morning. A lot of you guys don't realize, you know, we shoot muscle in the morning the day before, so that Johnny has time to edit it, put it up, and so we're here on a Sunday night, you know, ready to do muscle in the morning with all the latest breaking news stories for tomorrow morning. You guys get to see, and I'm going to give you a little sneak preview of how we do it. So stay tuned and watch, and you might even catch a couple bloopers that I do that don't actually make it to the final cut. Let me bring you over here and show you Johnny Styles. Johnny Styles got his little teleprompter set up here. We don't want to show too much because this is the secret magic that makes this work. Now, Johnny, you just got back from Southern States today.
Yes, I got it.
What was the most impressive thing you saw in Florida?
I saw big wellness people over there.
Oh, they had a wellness? They didn't have wellness division,
no,
did
but
they?
No, they haven't working around.
But you told me there's a lot of people with butt implants that were
yes,
very disappointed
yes,
to you.
Yes, very disappointed because they look good from the front, but then we jump in the back. It's
now, is it the Cubans? Is that who has the butt implants?
A lot of Cubans, a lot of Dominicans there with
really?
Butt implants.
All right, well, Johnny's very disappointed in that. But how was Flex Lewis? Because he looked amazing.
He looked really good. And John De La Rosa was really good, too. Cool. And I heard that Evan was good and was pale. But he was good.
Santapani was there. I didn't realize that. Okay, well, we're going to catch a little sneak preview probably in Muscle in the Morning of Flex Lewis. So, guys, this is how the magic happens. Welcome to another episode of Muscle in the Morning, brought to you by Iron Mag Labs, the most hardcore bodybuilding supplements on the market. I'm your host, Dave Palumbo, and I'm here to bring you all the latest news in the world of bodybuilding and fitness. It's Monday, July 14th, 2014, and on today's show, Phil Heath in White Plains, New York. Mr. 5% gets a new tattoo, help save women's bodybuilding, the NPC Southern States, and Michelle Lewin's Fun in the Sun. All that and much, much more only on Muscle in the Morning. Three-time Mr. Olympia Phil Heath launched his brand new supplement line late last week and was in New York over the weekend guest posing at the NPC Northeast Summer Classic. Take two. Three-time Mr. Olympia Phil Heath launched his brand new supplement line late last week and was in New York over this weekend. Three-time Mr. Olympia Phil Heath, take three, take four. Three-time Mr. Olympia Phil Heath launched his brand new supplement line late last week and was in New York over the weekend, guest posing at the NPC Northeast Summer Classic. We're here at my favorite diner, the East Bay Diner, and this is the end of the day. It's almost 10:30. We had a long, long day, as you can witness. I have my first course, my matzo ball chicken noodle soup. If you don't live on Long Island, you probably don't know what a matzo ball is, but it's a Jewish thing. And it's, I don't even, it's made with matzo brei and eggs and stuff like that. It's delicious. Start out with maybe just, actually in this diner, they actually have their own homemade coleslaw too, which I usually start with them. So officially, this is first. Matzo ball chicken noodle soup second. My salad's coming right there, third. Talk to you about this. Got the olive oil and vinegar. Take a little olive oil. As you can see, I put a lot on. Probably 2 tablespoons of yeast, maybe 3. Salt. I'm a big believer in salt. They burn a lot of, lose a lot of electrolytes. A little pepper, maybe. And I'm good. All right, I'm going to eat my soup, I'm going to eat my salad, and then you'll see my main course when it comes out. This place has got the biggest, best portions of any diner I've ever been to. All right, the main course is here. They ran out of spinach tonight. 10:30 tonight, that's what happens. If you notice, I got a humongous, I actually started eating it already. Huge piece of salmon. This is like a pound of salmon at least. I got rice. Nice little rice. Not too much seasoning in it. I got some broccoli coming. This is my meal I eat at night. I go home, have maybe a couple fruits, I fiberize, and I go to sleep. That's pretty much it. So, guys, I guess we'll do one more little clip snip at home when I'm getting ready to go to bed, and you'll see what a complete day in the life of Dave Palumbo is like. I'm home for the night now. The day's almost over. I just got back from the diner, ate. I gotta take my night pills. I got my V-mineralized from Species Nutrition. Complete chelated mineral and vitamin formula, also with a nice blueberry extract and lycopene, phytonutrient, polyphenolic component. take my 5 in the morning. I take 5 at night. I take my arthrolyze for my joints. This is my second dose. I take another 5 here. That's another 2,000 milligrams of glucosamine, 2,000 MSM. I already took 2,000 earlier in the day. I have my CoQ10. That. I have my vitamin K. I don't make these in species, so I take Life Extension Super Booster Gels. I take my Omega Lyse for all my essential fats. This is my second dose of the day. I'm going to be taking 3 pills of these. I took 3 earlier. That's 1,300 milligrams of primrose oil in this dose and 1,500 of omega-3 fish oil. I will take, I took another early in the morning. Okay. The great thing is you're going to see me take them all in one shot. I got my vitamin D, a little extra vitamin D, never hurts. Everyone, 87% of Americans are vitamin D deficient. I actually have vitamin D in V-mineralize, but I take a little extra as well. And then sometimes what I'll do for good measure, I'll throw some cracked, this is Tony Freeman told me to do this, organic broken cell wall chlorella. So sometimes I do that when I have a rough workout. A little alkalinization of the body. And I'm trying to give you a nice little show. Now here's all my pills. Okay, right into the gut, right down the gullet. One shot. Down the hatch, good as gold. This day is over. Sunday, July 13th. A day in my life.